The first step we do is we have the greens laser scanned in the summertime when the green surface is perfectly smooth. The next step is to remove the sod. And in removing the sod, our goal is to recut the sod as thin as possible. That's key for us because we don't want to be putting back an excessive layer of thatch or mat. Then what we do is we have to recreate the lost green contours. So we'll recreate the green and get the wings back, and then we take that laser scanner and re-scan the green a second time so that we have the lost contours. And once we're happy with that scan, we then shell the green out, core it out. You dig the green down 16 inches below the surface so that the floor of the green will mimic the top. Once the green is cored out, we install the drainage. And after the drainage is done, we install the 4 inches of a gravel blanket. And after the gravel blanket is installed, we put the USGA mix in, and we pack that, tamp that, wet it, get it really firm.
Every superintendent would love to have a certain degree of predictability and consistency. That all really starts with the soil structure, and the modified soil structure of a USGA green gives us the best chance for the superintendent to get more consistency out of his turf grass.
And we then do what we call the strike-off. We have to get the green back precise. And we're using a surveying instrument called a total robotic station. And that robotic station has the data from the scans that's downloaded into it and has a little computer on it that tells us cut or fill. So we're actually getting these greens back to 0.005 thousandths of a surveying foot. That final process takes 5 or 6 man crew, 20 to 30 hours of that crew. Once that's done, we scan the green for the third time to make sure that we've accomplished what we wanted to in the changes from the first scan to the second scan. And once that's approved, we can then sod. And after that's done, then we start immediately top dressing the green. We actually take pastry bags and fill it with sand, and we hand fill in all the seams between all the sod, and then start rolling it and then start maintaining it like a normal green.
At the end of the day, you know, superintendents are still gonna work hard when it comes down to a USGA green, but they're going to have the opportunity for the end user, for the member, to get on back on the greens faster, for the greens to be firmer and drier right after a rainstorm.
When Tillinghast built these greens, or when any greens were built 80, 90, 100 years ago, they're built to hold moisture. Moisture's now our enemy. We don't want to hold moisture. So the USGA green is sand-based, so it drains, so it allows us the ability to manage moisture better. It allows for firmer greens, faster greens. So it's modernization. We're changing the infrastructure, but keeping the contours of these greens, which is so fascinating about this, that we're able to do both those things.